In a previous video, we talked about how to scrape leads from Google Maps. And one cannot deny that both the Yellow Pages and Google Maps are pretty similar to one another. Indeed, they both target small businesses based on a particular location. But one might wonder why I do create this tutorial then. Well, for at least two reasons. The first one is that scraping the US Yellow Pages is much easier. Secondly, when they are available, you can scrape emails on the Yellow Pages, which is not the case on Google Maps. You might also remind me that I already created two tutorials related to the same topic a year ago. And precisely, it was a year ago. And I think we can do a better job now. We can do things in a more professional way. One last thing. If you want to scrape thousands of leads, including emails, you can also use scrape.io. I worked for the people who offer this service, so I do recommend them. The link is in the description. I think the promotional time is over. Let's jump into the tutorial. If you want to follow this tutorial, you can download Octoparse. It's a freemium web scraping tool. The link is also in the description. As a perfect French guy, I'm looking for bakeries in New York City. Of course, you can choose whatever category you desire. I've got my URL. I copy and paste my URL on Octoparse. In order to build our web scraper, I click on start. The first thing we're gonna do is to create our pagination. The purpose of a pagination is to jump from one page to another one. In other words, we will scrape data from as many pages as possible. And in order to do so, we'll create a loop and we're gonna click on the next page button as many times as possible. So I click on it and I click on loop click next page. I've got my pagination, I've got my click to paginate, and I set up a higher Ajax timeout. I'm gonna check whether my pagination works or not. We are on page 2. If I click on pagination and click to paginate, we should end up with the page 3. So let's wait a little bit. Let's scroll down to the bottom of the page. And now we are on page 3. So our pagination works. However, if you want to be more precise, you can also add some XPaths. The XPaths helps you to precisely localize an element within a web page. All the XPaths we're gonna add will be written in the description, but please note that they might change over time. For instance, if I want to input this XPath, I copy it, I go to pagination and I paste it here, but it's the very same one, so it doesn't change. Once we have done our pagination, we should do our loop item. Basically, our loop item will create a loop for all of the items in our page. So let's think about it a minute. We don't want to select the sponsored items. We only want to select the elements starting with a number. So 1, 2, 3, from 1 to 30, from 31 to 60 on the second page, and so on. We can create a loop item by doing this. I can select the first element just like this, the entire element. I click on it. It's selected in green. I redo the same process on the second element, and I've got 28 elements selected. As you can notice, this way of doing things is not really accurate, and this is the reason why we can use this XPath. I undo action, I create a loop between my pagination and my click to paginate button. Let's add a loop. I click on it, and I change the loop mode from list of URLs to variable list, which, one more time, makes sense because we want to get a list of elements. I paste my XPath. I click on apply. If I click on my loop item one more time, I've got 30 elements. I'm gonna show you how I end up with this XPath. It may be helpful for those who want to write their own XPath. So let's do this one together. In order to write my XPath, I have to take a look at the HTML code of my web page. So I inspect this element, I click and select an element in the page to inspect it, and let's select the entire element. I've got this particular element, but if I select the parent, it's still okay, the element is still selected, and I've got div class result. Basically, the tag is equal to div, the attribute is class, and the value is result. Once I'm aware of this, I can use the XPath helper, which is a really useful Chrome extension if you want to write and verify your XPaths. And my XPath will be the following: //div square brackets at attribute class equal to my value. So result, I close my square brackets and I've got 30 elements. It's written over here and all the selected elements are highlighted in yellow. And this is the very same one as the one we have written here. What are we gonna do next? If we want to select as much data as we want, we have to jump into the detail page for each element. In other words, I have to click on the title, I have to open link in a new tab, and then we can extract some useful data like the title, like the phone number, the address, the website, and the email when it's available. I come back to Octoparse and I'm gonna click and the first URL. I click on the title and there is something very, very paramount. I have to make sure that the last element I have selected is an A element because an A tag represents a URL. Here I selected a span element, which is not good. So I click on the A element instead. Then I click on click URL. I go to the options. I make sure that open in a new tab is checked. I click on apply. You can change the XPath if needed. I think it's better if you do it actually. I copy my XPath. I paste it here. I check it out one more time. So we are here on the listing page. I click on click item and we end up with the detail page. It's time to extract our data. You've got two options. You can do a point and click if I want to get the phone number, I click on the phone number and I click on extract text of the selected element. It's fast and easy, but it's not accurate enough in my opinion. So I might suggest you to use the XPath instead. So let's do the first one together and then you repeat the same process. I add a step, I extract data, I click on add custom field, capture data on the page, I add a name. Let's start with the title and I copy and paste my XPath related to my colon. I confirm and I've got the title and I see you back once it's over. There are a couple of changes we can make. To begin with, I'm gonna add the URL of this detail page. I add custom field, page level data, and page URL. I'm also going to modify the content of my colon. For instance, I've got the phone number, which is good, but I've also got the phone text, and I want to remove it. I click on more, clean data, add step and replace with regular expression. And if I want to remove this part, I type phone, I don't know how to call this character, /s+, which means a line break or a space character. And the plus is one or more. If I click on evaluate, I've only got my phone number, which is good. I click on confirm and on apply. I do the same thing for the address. I want to replace this part /s+ by nothing, so it will simply remove it. What about the emails and the price range, because there is no email and there is no price range on this web page. So I'm gonna try out with another detailed page. Let's take a look at the second element. I click on apply. I click on click item. I wait until the web page is loaded and I click on extract data. Now we've got an email and we've got a price range. There is no problem with the price range. However, we didn't directly get the email. We've got the email business text. We click on more, we click on customize field and select URL. I've got mail to plus the company's email. Then I clean my data. I replace, a simple replace should be enough. And I replace this part by nothing. I confirm, I apply, and I've got my email address. Finally, we ought to add some timeouts in our workflow. It will help us to build a safe scraper. I click on extract data. Let's add a 10 seconds timeout here. Let's say 1 second here. 1 second on my loop item. And 1 second on the pagination. We can run our task. I click on run and I click on standard mode. You can wait until your task is completed, but I think it's enough. I just wanted to show you that the workflow works. I can stop my task and export my data. You can remove your duplicates if there are any. And let's export the data in an Excel format. And here is what it should look like. This is the end of the video. I hope you have enjoyed it. If it's the case, feel free to give a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. And if you want another way to scrape leads from small businesses, you've still got scrap.io. The link remains in the description. See you next time.